Hi, my dear students. Last class, we discussed about eddy currents and the shape of the eddy currents and how the eddy currents are produced and what are the drawbacks of eddy currents. In this class, we are going to discuss about applications of eddy current, that means uses of eddy currents, where the eddy currents are used. Now, in this class, I will explain the three applications of eddy currents. What are the three applications of eddy currents? First one, that is electromagnetic brakes. Second one, electromagnetic damping. Third one, speedometer. First one is electromagnetic brakes. What is the use of eddy currents in the electromagnetic brakes? Now, you are going to see, just listen. A strong electromagnet is placed just above the rails and which is connected with the wheels. That means it is placed just above the rails. When the wheels of the train rotates according to the speed of the vehicle, when the wheels of the train rotates, that means the wheels of the train are moving with the strong electromagnet which is placed in the wheels. So when the wheel rotates, that means the train is moving, a strong electromagnet above the rails also moving. So there is a change in the magnetic flux around the rails. So EMF is induced in the rails, an eddy current is produced inside the rails. This eddy current strongly opposes the motion of the wheels of the train. That is a damping force, which provides a damping force. So, which opposes the motion of the wheels of the train, according to Lenz's law. So, the wheels of the train immediately comes into rest when the brake is applied. Why? Only when the brake is applied, the electromagnet is switched on. Otherwise, the electromagnet is switched off. So, the train will go. There is no damping force here. When the electromagnet is switched on, then when the brakes are applied, the electromagnet is switched on, then only immediately eddy currents are induced, which will oppose the motion of the wheels of the train and the train immediately comes to rest. This is called electromagnetic linear brake. There are two systems in electromagnetic brakes. One is electromagnetic linear brake, another one is electromagnetic circular brake. What is electromagnetic circular brake? In this case, the wheel of the train is connected to a circular disc with the help of a shaft. Okay, the wheels of the train are connected to a disc, metal disc with the help of a shaft. When the wheels of the train rotates, the shaft rotates, so the metal disc also rotates. Here the brakes are applied, the magnet which provides magnetic field. Only when the brakes are applied, the magnet provides a magnetic field around the rotating disc. So eddy currents are produced because of the varying magnetic flux. Eddy currents are produced in the disc, which opposes the motion of the disc. The disc is connected to the wheel of the train, so which opposes the motion of the wheel of the train. Then the wheel of the train immediately comes to rest and the train stops. This is called electromagnetic circular brake. So there are two braking system. One is electromagnetic linear brake, another one is electromagnetic circular brake. With the help of eddy current, we can use these brakes. This is first application. The second application is electromagnetic damping. What is electromagnetic damping? I will give the clear explanation about electromagnetic damping in the next video. Please wait. Thank you.